Good afternoon, and welcome to Midday Music at Myers Park. My name is Evan Wesley Currie. I'm the Associate Director of Music and Organist here at this marvelous church. It's just always a pleasure to have each and every one of you joining us for this series. Today's program I'm actually really excited about because it features dance. And we all know that we love to dance, whether you dance in the shower or whether you dance in the car or dance professionally. I was exposed to dance as a very, very young child because my sister actually would take jazz, tap, contemporary, modern. And so I always rode with my parents to pick her up and always went to her recitals. And I just always loved how everybody was dancing. And there were different types of dance, from tangos to waltzes to ballads, anything that you can think of. And so it's only fitting that musicians and composers would take inspiration from that and put it into their music. So today I'm joined by Robert Moody on cello, and we've actually had a really fun time just working on this program. The opening piece that you're gonna hear is actually a short work by Ian Hunt called Toccata Giocosa. And it's really just a dance of the trumpets between my hands and my feet. And it's just a really fun piece, I thought, to open the program. Later on, Robert will be talking about the two pieces that he is playing and that we worked on together. And then the last two pieces on the program are actually the waltz in C sharp minor by Friedrich Chopin. So a waltz is definitely a piece that in Poland, you know, or excuse me, not a piece in Poland, but a dance in Poland that was very famous. And so he obviously put it into his music. And so you'll kind of hear the dance theme of the one, two, three, one, two, three. And I just thought it was a really charming piece that really captured kind of a different spirit of dance that we may not hear today in today's modern society. The last piece is a little, well, not a little, very far left of center. It's the Ruvido ed Ostinato by Hina Stir. It's from his first piano sonata. And both he and Chopin were nationalist composers, meaning that they took inspiration from their country and the culture that they had, especially their dance, and put it into their music. So you'll hear that it's really this South American, Latin-themed piece that just has mixed meter, is kind of all over the piano, but it has this repeated figure both in the right hand and the left hand. And it's actually meant to mimic the gauchos or the Argentinian cowboys. So you'll see later on in the program as we close that out how they all contrast. Again, we just want to thank you all for being here today. It's always a pleasure to have you joining us for this series. We enjoy putting together this music every 2 weeks, but we also enjoy hearing your support and your comments. It's really just uplifting to us as we're here during COVID, just trying to provide a little bit of reprieve from your work week, whatever you might be going through. So we hope you enjoy this dance program on Midday Music at Myers Park.
Hi, my name is Robert Moody. I'm a member of the music program, the chamber choir, the chancel choir here at Myers Park United Methodist. I also am something of an amateur cellist these days, but it's a great program, this dance program, to feature some works that show the cello in different dancing variations. I'll introduce the works you're going to hear in reverse order. So the final work that will feature the cello, Evan Currie and I will play together. It's a work called Tango Bittersweet by composer Fred Hirsch. Fred Hirsch is a composer, jazz musician, and very well known for his activism in the fight against HIV and AIDS. He actually wrote this piece, which became part of a very well known and loved album called Memento Bittersweet. This came out in the early 90s, and the unique factor of this album is that works by every composer on the album is a person who either has passed away from or is living with HIV or AIDS. This particular piece of Fred Hirsch's is connected to the title of the album. It's called Tango Bittersweet. So before the tango, a completely different style of music, work of Johann Sebastian Bach. J.S. Bach wrote 6 suites for unaccompanied cello. They are some of the most beloved and, I dare say, near perfect works in all of the repertory. They're a desert island pieces for me. Interesting about these works, which were written during the Baroque era in the very early 18th century, other than the prelude to each suite, the rest of the movements are, by and large, dance movements. So I'm going to play for you 2 of the movements from his first suite, which is in G major, the Sarabande movement followed immediately by the Gigue. The Sarabande is, well, it's a Baroque slow dance, if you will, and then the Gigue is a very up and up-tempo, fun way to finish the suite.